In this lecture, let's cover pronouns. Pronouns are those parts of speech that replace nouns, nouns in the sentence, which means that if I'm using one or the other noun too many times, for example, if I keep saying Swati is a great girl, Swati will be able to do that, Swati is going out and doing this, it does not really sound very intelligible. It sounds something that is repetitive and boring. This is why we use pronouns. We'll just replace Swati with she, and this is how it looks like. Swati is very intelligent. She is going to do this for us. She is going to go out and complete that work, and so on. So the main reason that we use pronouns is fun, to make sentences less redundant and more intelligent. There are different types of pronouns. Okay. Now, when you go into the whole detail, there will be a lot of types of pronouns that we'll be referencing, but we don't need all of those. I'm just going to give you the names of them. Like, for example, we have personal pronouns. Well, we have possessive pronouns. We have subject pronouns. We have object pronouns. We have a lot of other varieties of pronouns, for example, there are demonstrative pronouns, there are interrogative pronouns. But all of this is just, you know, going down the whole detail level that we don't need to. So let's focus on the three major types, which are subject pronoun, object pronoun, and possessive pronouns. Okay, so subject pronouns are those pronouns which are used in place of nouns that act as the subject of the sentence, which means that subject pronouns are the doers in the sentence. If I say, she killed the rabbit. Now, in this sentence, the she, the pronoun here is she. She pronoun is used to, the, you know, replace the female nouns. Okay. Now, she killed the rabbit. The she here is a subject pronoun. Similarly, he, they, all of these, I, are subject pronouns. They are the doers in the sentence. She, they, I, he, they all do things. They are responsible for something. I did it. I ate it. He loved it. He was amazing in the game, and so on. So that is subject pronoun. Things are being done by them. Now, object pronouns. Object pronouns get things done on them. Okay, they are object pronouns, which means the job was given to him. Now, in these sentences, the doer, okay, or the subject may be or may not be present. For example, take a look here. This is the doer in sentence 2. This is the doer in sentence 2. Sentence 3, but there is no apparently present subject in sentence 1. But we are not concerned with that, just take a look at the object here. The job was given to him, which means that the person was given the job. Okay, so something was done to him. Killing her, she was killed. Okay, so someone else killed her, which means that that process or that work was done on her. Okay, so her, him, and me become the object pronouns, right? And lastly, the third type is the possessive pronouns. The possessive pronouns denote ownership, which means that when you want to say something belongs to you, you use a process possessive pronoun. So the sentences would be, the killed rabbit, the dead rabbit is not mine. The theory was his, and so on. So here we are trying to say that this person owns something, this person owns something. In this case, it does not own something. In this case, it does own something. The ownership idea. Okay? So, the ownership in possessive pronouns. In objective pronouns, you have things done on them. So, they are the objects. And here, they are the subjects. The doers. Okay? So, you get it? Pronouns are words that replace nouns. He, she, it, they, theirs. Even reflexive pronouns are something like this: yourself, myself, and so on. These are reflexive pronouns. Okay, all these pronouns replace nouns in a sentence. That is all that you need to know. What are these types of pronouns? Read them, read all the list that you can find out, and be aware of the nouns that you use in a sentence. We'll be using a lot of these words in the rules that we'll be following next. Okay? Best of luck.